You're what's going on, man? Y'all know who it is. Y'all know what it is. Your boy Philly Fresh, aka the General, man. Here reporting for duty, man. Ah, cool guy today. Got the shades on. You see him? But first of all, man, in all seriousness, I hope everybody is being safe out this joint, man. Somebody I know just got the COVID-19, aka the coronavirus. You know, hopefully they get through it, man. It's real. You know what I mean? It's real. Whoever feel as though is not, they not watching the news. I don't want to get in conspiracies and all that kind of stuff, government stuff, and that's not what this page is for. But I do want y'all to recognize that this thing that's going on, this virus, is real and it's killing people. It's killed thousands of people. So make sure, man, you're doing what you gotta do, man. Wash your hands, gloves. I just put this mask together, man. You know, Gucci duck, man. But in all seriousness, man, make sure you're doing what you gotta do, man. Cause it's real out here. Now let's get to the video, man. This video is something that I have not talked about since the off season. It's one person that I have not talked about this whole off season. And y'all know how I feel about this one person. I have not talked about Carson Wentz this whole offseason, man. And last time I went live with Gate City and Philly Talk Podcast, shout out to y'all too. We had a discussion about this. Where does Carson rank with you? To me, I said top five without even stuttering. Palms not shaking. Top five, man. Now, it could be some discrepancy of what's going on with what I'm saying. It's because a lot of dudes want to still have Breeze and they still want to have Tom Brady up there. We're not talking about lifetime achievement awards. We're not talking about how many Super Bowls you got. We're not talking about the past. We're talking about from last year going on to the future. Who do you think top five is? And what they can produce? Now, let's X off Tom Brady. Tom Brady arm is going. I understand he going to a team that got a lot of playmakers, but I still feel as though he can't get that ball down the field. And a lot of them receivers like Mike Evans will be frustrated because they're used to somebody that slings the ball. Pause. But seriously, in all seriousness, I got to get Tom Brady out of here. Drew Brees has declined too. His last two postseasons, he hasn't been good. Let's just keep it real. It's probably about two or three quarterbacks right now that I would just say, hell no, Carson Wentz ain't better than him. I'm not biased. I understand that Carson is not the best. He is not the best quarterback in the league. He is not the best quarterback in the NFC. That title goes to Russell Wilson. Believe it or not, Russell Wilson is the best quarterback in the NFC. Point blank, period. This dude, and here's why I say that, and here is why I'm going to show you why Carson Wentz is number five. Because what Carson Wentz did, not to that extent, but what Carson Wentz did the last five games of the season, yes, I said five, even in the Miami game, he put up 31 points and should have won that game, okay? So the last five games of the season, right? Russell Wilson has not to the extent that Carson Wentz did it with the practice squad guys, but Russell Wilson really hasn't had really a number one receiver. You know what I mean? He had Josh Gordon for about a game or two, but he really hasn't really had a number one receiver. He had dudes that can go and can make plays. Now to Carson Wentz, them last five games, man, doing what he did with the talent that he had, I don't care who you played against. And it's not like the Washington football team defense is just trash. It's not. They hold dudes to points, to lesser points, should I say. They're not just trash. They probably was middle of the pack. It wasn't like the deep. Now the offense, that's something different. Now the defense was around middle of the pack that's last season, right? And then you got the throws that only the throw is three people that can make the throws that these three people can make. Probably four. Right? because you want to put Aaron Rodgers in there too. I understand that. He still can make all type of throws. He's getting a little up there, but who knows? So you got your Patrick Mahomes, you got your Russell Wilson, you got your Carson Wentz, you got your Aaron Rodgers. Them four players can make throws that nobody else in the league can make. That throw to Miles Sanders' touchdown against the Washington football team was the most underrated throw last year to me. Because when Russell Wilson made that throw, everybody piped it up. It was on it was on all these commercials and the probable him making that catch, and the catch was way better than the throw to me. And that's no dispersions on Russell Wilson. It looked like he just threw it up there and was hoping, I'm going to put it to where my quarterback can get it. I mean, to where my receiver can get it. Or it's going out of balance. Most likely it'll go out of balance. But his receiver made a hell of a catch. That throw to Miles Sanders in the corner of the end zone against the Washington football team was a hell of a throw. That throw was so on point. It just seemed like Miles Sanders had the will himself to make sure he didn't mess that play up. But it didn't get as much recognition as Russell Wilson throw. I feel as though Carson Wentz, just because he played in the NFC East, who a lot of people are saying, dudes like Max Kellerman, a lot of people are saying that it was the weakest league, it was the weakest division ever. How? The Seahawks won the AFC West 7-9. So that means everybody else had to be worse than 7-9. We won it at 9-7. Think about it. It's not hard. It's not hard. It's math. 7-9, 9-7. So people are trying to take away from what Carson Wentz did. Carson Wentz is a top five quarterback. Try to prove me wrong, man. Second half of this video coming up, but first, a word from my sponsor. You see it, BBC, Bodybuilders Collision, take care of you, man, 108 East Baltimore Pike. If you're in a tri-state area, you get into a fender bender, or you just might need an estimate, you need a mirror, you need a door, whatever the case may be, BBC will take care of you. As for Diddy, tell them Philly Fresh sent you, and they'll take good care of you, man. Second half of the video. Hold on, let me take my shades off, man, because this is real serious to me. No, 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 hell no. I don't want Cam Newton. For what? For what? To bring some type of turmoil in, to bring the so-called Superman in and take over press conferences. It's a reason why we didn't bring in, Colin Kaepernick. You know, like, it's too much headlines. You know what I mean? It's too much going on, and I'm not saying Carson would have to, but you don't want your quarterback looking over their shoulder, oh, I might get hurt, like, and playing like that. You seen how freely, you know, Carson Wentz played when he didn't have Nick Foles over. You know what I mean? Like, when somebody is battling for your job, even if you're better than them, you just feel as though I can't make this mistake. I can't make that mistake. And you don't play as freely if it's somebody that's not battling for your job, like a Nate Sudfeld. Do I think we need a veteran quarterback? Yeah, but just not Cam. It's going to bring, I don't know how the locker room would treat him, you know, with the fly talking and coming to the press conferences with the wigs and dress, not wigs, but the dresses and the hats and, oh man, nah, I'm good. I'm good, man. I'm real good. Let me know what y'all think in the comments. Y'all know what it is. Stay Philly, stay fresh, y'all.